estamos cerca. De bandera la ilusión y preparando la acción, que la cordura lo tiene cerca. Que con instinto animal sabes, a muchas fieras para domar, por eso mismo mueren de pie.
On December 10, 2013, Uruguay became the first nation in the world to legalize cannabis.
Debate lasted almost 13 hours, but long before it was over, crowds were already cheering in the streets.
While the plant was decriminalized in the small Latin American country in 1974, buying, selling, and growing cannabis was still prohibited. The new legislation closes the gap by regulating the use of the drug for medical, recreational, scientific, and industrial purposes. According to polls, about two-thirds of Uruguayans oppose a government-run cannabis industry. Also, there are only about 120,000 cannabis users in the nation of about 3 million people. But 76-year-old President Jose Mujica, who is adored in his home country, said he is convinced the global drug war is a failure and the new law will do a better job of containing addictions and stopping organized crime than current methods.
Todas las medidas policiales que hemos emprendido en los últimos 100 años contra el tráfico de droga han multiplicado los crímenes, multiplicaron el delito, la droga se fue extendiendo y las sociedades se llenaron de violencia.
Especially in Latin America.
Sí. Nuestro criterio es tratar de arrebatarle el mercado a un negocio clandestino y ponerlo a la luz del día. Pero no es que el que quiera va a consumir y va a comprar lo que quiera. No. Es una regulación. Vamos a ofrecer en las farmacias donde se vende el remedio, vamos a ofrecer una dosis mensual a la gente que se registre. Cuando requiera más, nos damos cuenta que a esa persona la tenemos que tratar. Y entonces lo vamos a tratar como una cuestión médica, como un problema de salud. Pero para eso los tenemos que identificar, sacarlos de la clandestinidad.
We had two options: to fight drug trafficking and forbid marijuana consumption, or let the state regulate a market worth $40 million a year instead of leaving it to dealers on the streets.
Uruguay has one of the lowest crime rates in Latin America, but drug-related violence is growing, and the government says it's time to attack the profits of the drug cartels before they become too powerful.
Establecer cuáles son las reglas para jugar este partido.
The current drug market is like a football game without rules. What we are doing is setting those rules. We are not in favor of a law that promotes consumption, and we don't say that smoking marijuana has no consequences or is risk-free. No.
The reason organized crime is involved in drug trafficking is not because drugs themselves are inherently valuable. They cost pennies to produce. These are minimally processed agricultural commodities that are naturally worth very little. But because our politicians keep escalating the war on drugs, to trying to get tough, it increases the risk to the drug traffickers. That allows them to charge a tremendous, an astronomical risk premium to the next person down the smuggling chain. So that's how you transform a relatively worthless pile of vegetable matter into something that is so priceless that people are willing to kill and die for it.
Will this put the drug dealers out of business?
For those that are dealing in marijuana, yes, you will not make money doing this. And that's the important thing for this moment in time. Uruguay sees what's happening in neighboring countries in terms of organized crime moving in, not just with marijuana, but the same people who sell marijuana also sell cocaine and also crack and other forms of cocaine that are much more dangerous. And what they've done is separate then the dealer from who sells marijuana may as well sell you something addictive, more powerful, because they want to maximize profits. So the state says we're going to break that link between the so-called soft drugs and the hard drugs.
Martin Collazo, a member of the Responsible Regulation Coalition, said public health will benefit most from the law. 85% of users of illegal drugs in Uruguay only consume cannabis, which means the black market could shrink by a similar percentage, he argues. Based on Uruguay's bold moves to legalize cannabis and gay marriage, The Economist named Uruguay Country of the Year in 2013. A Dutch NGO called the Drugs Peace Institute also nominated President Mujica for a Nobel Peace Prize. It is easy to understand the admiration for this man.
Talk to Al Jazeera went to visit the man described as the world's poorest president at his tiny farmhouse home outside of Montevideo. There are no bodyguards, no butlers, just Mujica's three-legged dog, Manuela.
Mr. President, you are not only about to legalize marijuana, you have already legalized abortion, gay marriage, and by the way, you're also an atheist. How do you feel about the fact that you are being described so much lately as the world's poorest president?
No, pobres son los que me describen. Pobres, mi definición es la de Seneca. Pobres son los que precisan mucho. Porque si precisa mucho, es insaciable. Yo soy sobrio, no pobre. Sobrio.
Speaking of money, you give 90% of your salary to charity. You live with very little.
El problema es que yo tengo un padrón y una forma de vivir que no la cambio por ser presidente. Entonces me sobra. A otro tal vez no le alcance, pero a mí me sobra.
Time has not dampened Mujica's idealism. He considers himself a man of the land and a pacifist. But as a young Marxist, he took up arms against the government, was imprisoned and only released after an amnesty was declared in 1985. He spent 11 of 15 years in solitary confinement.
Hannah Hetzer, policy manager for the Americas at the Drug Policy Alliance, called Uruguay's cannabis legislation the most advanced in the world. Hetzer has been advising the Uruguayan government based on laws developed in other parts of the world, including the U.S., where cannabis is legal in Colorado and Washington and allowed for medicinal purposes in many other states. Uruguayan cannabis legalization, which goes into effect April 2014, will be regulated by the Institute for the Regulation and Control of Cannabis, a new government institution created by the law. The delay gives the government time to decide the type of cannabis to be planted, who will grow it and at what cost, and how much they will charge for the drug, among other regulations. Cannabis sales are expected to bring the small Latin American country about $20 million annually. Under the new legislation, residents of Uruguay 18 years of age or older can purchase up to 40 grams of cannabis a month after signing up for a federal registry. Individuals are also permitted to grow up to 6 plants, or 480 grams a year. The law excludes tourists in an attempt to prevent Uruguay from becoming a marijuana paradise. However, countries that permit the medicinal use of cannabis, including Canada, Chile, and Israel, are now looking to Uruguay for supply. Both government representatives and private firms have contacted the Uruguayan government with interest in participating in the nation's planned cannabis market. Diego Canepa, a spokesman for the Uruguayan presidency, said, "While it wasn't an objective of the law, Uruguay is becoming a biotechnology center. It's not just legal cannabis that makes Uruguay attractive."
Uruguay's drug czar says the country plans to sell legal marijuana for $1 per gram.
The 26,000 Canadians who use legal medicinal cannabis currently pay about $5 or more per gram. Of course, Uruguay's new cannabis legislation received pushback from those who would like the plant to remain prohibited.
He did talk a little bit about other countries that are pressuring him to keep marijuana illegal. Two of those countries are Brazil and the United States. Now, the United States is no surprise. Brazil is really no surprise either, especially when you consider that their drug laws haven't really made much sense. They've been criminalizing drugs for a very long time, such as the United States. And as a result, drug violence is very high, drug consumption is very high.
The president of the International Narcotics Control Board, a UN agency, criticized Mujica for not meeting with the UN prior to legalizing the plant in Uruguay. Mujica insisted his administration is open to discussing the law and accused the INCB President Raymond Yans of applying a double standard by criticizing Uruguay as U.S. states pass laws to legalize recreational cannabis. Mujica pointed out that the populations of Colorado and Washington, where cannabis is now legal, exceed Uruguay's national population. Mujica asked, "Do they have two discourses, one for Uruguay and another for those who are strong?" With Uruguay's new cannabis legislation, neighboring Argentina, a longtime proponent of cannabis prohibition, gave an indication that Uruguay has tempted Argentina to consider legalizing the drug. The head of Argentina's counter-narcotics agency, Juan Carlos Molina, said, "Argentina deserves a good debate about this. We have the capacity to do it. We shouldn't underestimate ourselves." Mexico, Chile, Ecuador, and Peru are also considering cannabis law reform thanks to Uruguay's new legislation.
Flores viene a pisar y vuelven a florecer.